Hello, this is Dr. Bahauddin Abdullah, and this is the second part of testing series. We will apply the different tests we know to determine whether each series is convergent or divergent. Let us start by this one. We know that ln n over square root of n using the integral test is divergent. So summation absolute value of a n is divergent by the integral test, or even you can use the comparison test, because ln n when n greater than starting from 3 is greater than 1, and this series is divergent, so this is divergent by the comparison test. But also you can prove that this series using alternating series test is convergent, and the derivative of ln x over square root of x is given by this. It's less than 0 when x greater than e square, so it is decreasing, and the limit you can prove that it is 0 using L'Hopital's rule. So this series is conditionally convergent. Now let us look to this one. In fact, using the limit comparison test with 1 over n square, because the highest power here is n is 1, and here n cube, so n over n cube, 1 over n square. Use the limit comparison test to find limit a n over b n. It would be 1 greater than 0, and since this converges, so this series converges, absolutely convergent. Now for this question, if you find the limit of bn, it would be cosine limit 1 over n square, cosine 0, which is 1. So the limit of an would be plus or minus 1. So this series is divergent by the test for divergence. Now consider this example. In fact, this series is divergent also by the test for divergence, because the limit of a n is not 0. And you can, starting from sine between negative 1 and 1, prove that 1 over 2 sine k is between 1 over 3 and 1, in fact. So the limit of this is not 0, cannot be 0. It oscillates, because sine k oscillates between negative 1 and 1, so it's divergent. Now this is a nice example, tan 1 over n. This series is in fact divergent by using the limit comparison test with 1 over n. So if you take 1 over n, and if you find the limit of a n over b n, go to functions, because you will use L'Hopital's rule. If you find the derivative of the numerator and derivative of the denominator, you will find that the limit of a n over b n is 1, since 1 over n diverges, so this series diverges. Another one, n sine 1 over n. If you try to find the limit, it would be infinity times 0. Use functions, bring x down, write it 1 over x. Now it is sine 0 over 0, so 0 over 0. Use L'Hopital's rule, you will find it 1, which is not 0. So it is divergent by the test for divergence. For this series, you can use the ratio test, because you have powers and factorial, and this is absolute value of an plus 1 over an. Use L'Hopital's rule to find the derivative and to prove that the limit of this is in fact 0, which is less than 1, so this series is absolutely convergent. Same for this series, if you use ratio test, you will find that the limit is 1 over 5, because the limit of this is 1. 1 over 5 is less than 1, so it's absolutely convergent. For this series, if you start by comparing it, take plus 1, k plus 1 cube is greater than k cube, so you can write it less than. And now this is equal to ln k over k square, and this is convergent by the integral test. You can prove it, or even you can use the fact that ln k is less than square root of k, so it's less than square root of k over k square, 1 over k to the power 3 over 2, which is convergent. P series, p is greater than 1, so at the end this is convergent by comparison test. This is another example. Whenever you have e to the power 1 over n, you can use the fact that it is less than e. So e to the power 1 over n square is less than 1 over n square, or e over n square. You can take e out, and this is a convergent series, so by comparison test this is convergent. You should know the definition of cosine of cosh. Cosh n is in fact cosh x is e to the power x plus e to the power negative x over 2. So 1 over cosh x, if you consider summation absolute value, would be equal to this. And you can use comparison test, because en plus e to the power negative n is greater than en, so this is less than this, and this is a geometric series, 2 over e to the power n, 2 over e r is less than 1, so it's convergent, so this series is convergent. This series is convergent. This one would be absolutely convergent. Here, you can prove by alternating series test that it is convergent. While if you consider summation absolute value, you can prove that this series, summation square root of j over j plus 5, is divergent by limit comparison test with 1 over square root of j, because you subtract the highest powers. So this series is conditionally convergent. Here, if you find the limit of an, the highest power in the numerator is 5k, in the denominator 4k, then you will get this limit. Now you write it like this: 5 over 4 is greater than 1. We have a theorem that limit r to the power n when n goes to infinity is infinity if r is greater than 1, and this is r, 5 over 4 greater than 1. So the limit is infinity, so it's divergent by the test for divergence. This is a good candidate for the root test, because you have power n, if you use the root test, you will find that the limit of this will go to infinity, because n factorial is much higher than, much faster than n to the power 4, so it goes to infinity. So this is divergent by the root test. This is also another candidate for the root test. If you use the root test, you will find it like this. And we know that limit n plus 1 over n to the power n is e. Try to prove this. It's easy. Call y equal to this, and then apply ln y to both sides, and then prove that ln y goes to 1. So e to the power ln y goes to e to the power 1, so the limit is e. Now this is n over n plus 1, so it goes to e to the power negative 1, and that's less than 1, so it's absolutely convergent. For this example, if you start by the fact that cosine square n is less than 1, then you will find that n plus n cosine square is less than 2n, and the series or the sequence of terms is greater than 1 over 2n, and this is divergent, so this is divergent by the comparison test. The last example is a very nice example, and you solve it by the limit comparison test. Take 1 over n, bn, try to find the limit. It is not easy to find the limit. You need to use L'Hopital's rule. Okay. Use functions. Find the derivative of the numerator and then the derivative of the denominator. You will get, these two will cancel and you will get ln 2, because 1 over infinity is 0, 2 to the power 0 is 1. And ln 2 is greater than 0, and since b1 over n is divergent, so this series is divergent too. Good luck.